We're all members of a club no one wanted to join. Different backgrounds, ages, experiences. Thousands and thousands of us have been struggling for weeks and months with ongoing symptoms of COVID-19.
I've had a lot of problems with cognitive issues, so losing my words, misspelling things. At the moment, it's permanent chest pain, breathlessness, which gets worse on exertion, really, really severe fatigue.
Amy had COVID back in March, and since May, she says the ongoing symptoms from long COVID have left her practically housebound and barely able to work.
It feels like I've lost pretty much everything that makes me me, really. I don't feel useful, which is quite damaging, I think, to your mental health. I tried to get a referral to a post-COVID clinic, but it was rejected. And since then, really, I felt quite abandoned by the system.
With today's announcement of 69 specialist long COVID clinics, Amy hopes she might finally get a referral to one like this at UCLH in London. It was set up back in November and initially funded by a charity because doctors saw a need that wasn't being met.
I think patients, to some extent, have felt a bit abandoned, and maybe because when they've had tests which are normal, people sort of wash their hands of patients. What needs to be done is for the patients to be seen, to be listened to, examined, and then investigated.
With the first national guidance for GPs and health professionals on how to manage long COVID also published today, Amy and the many thousands of others living with the condition should now be able to access the help they need more easily. Jessica Savage, 5 News.